Hey guys, how's everybody doing? Thank you for watching Keto Transformation. My name is Nick, your beautiful host. Sorry I haven't been posting lately on both my channels. Things have been kind of hectic lately. Mom came into town the other day, so I've been visiting with family, and things are gonna settle down though. I just wanted to say things will calm down pretty soon, and I will get back to my normal schedule of daily posting. So stick in there, hang in there, guys. Thank you so much for sticking with me. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make an amazing dish, which reminds me of my late father. He showed me how to make cabbage rolls years ago, and this is just my take on a keto-friendly cabbage casserole. So it's really tasty. It's actually not a lot of prep work. The actual rolling of the cabbages was a lot more prep work. This cabbage casserole style is a lot less prep work, so, and it's really good, and you can have leftovers for a few days. It's real delicious, easy keto meal. So without further ado, guys, let's hop into the kitchen and I'll show you guys how to whip these up.
All right, guys, to make these delicious cabbage rolls, well, they're like cabbage casserole pretty much. I don't bother rolling them when I do this. So in here, I just have some fresh mushrooms chopped up fine and some onion and about 6 cloves of garlic chopped up. And then we're gonna add some ground beef. And we're gonna, instead of rice, we're gonna use cauliflower. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grate up about, depending on how much meat you're using. I'm not using a lot of meat, so I'd say about a quarter to a half of a small head of cauliflower. So go ahead and grate that up with a cheese grater, and we're gonna mix it all in there with our hamburger.
Okay, guys, so I got the cauliflower grated up here. Sorry, I'll buy a video card for my camera. I don't know why the video card I got's not working anymore, so we're just gonna have to use my cell phone for now, but I'll get one soon for my other camera. So in here, we're gonna add our meat. Remember, we got our onion, mushroom, and garlic all diced up. So go ahead and throw in some seasoning. I like to just put in a little bit of salt and pepper. I like it simple. Then we're gonna add the cauliflower. We're gonna make sure our hands are nice and clean, and then we're gonna mix it all up nice and good.
Okay, guys, so we got the salt, the pepper, the meat, the cauliflower rice, the mushrooms, the onions, the garlic, and like whatever seasoning you like. I just put garlic, salt, and pepper, okay? So we're gonna get in here and we're gonna mix it up real good, and then we're gonna line it in a baking pan. Make sure you wanna preheat your oven to about 400. One thing I forgot, sorry guys. We gotta add this, so we're gonna add this can of diced tomatoes or stewed tomatoes to this mixture, okay? Oh, and drain it before you add it. And then we're gonna mix all this up.
Okay, guys, so I got this mixed up with the tomatoes, with everything that goes in there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna slice up some cabbage, probably about half a head of cabbage, and then we're just gonna put it in there and mix it all up. And then I got some sausages that I'm gonna layer on top of this casserole. So after it's all mixed up, we're gonna layer it in our oven pan, and I'm gonna put some sausages on top. And we're gonna pop it in the oven for about an hour and 20 minutes, and it's gonna be delicious.
This cabbage casserole, it's all spread out evenly in the oven pan.
And then what I have here is a garlic coil sausage that I just sliced up, and I'm just gonna layer the whole thing with, and I also have this other, it's like kubasa or something. I'm making this dish in memory of my dad. He came from, I don't know, German ancestry or something, Ukrainian, and he's the one that taught me how to make cabbage rolls, and he passed away not this Christmas but last Christmas Eve, so this is kind of in memory of old.
Anyway,
Dean.
Guys, so just cover your whole casserole with sausage and then just pop it in the oven at like 400 degrees Fahrenheit
casserole
for about
an hour. It's all evenly smeared, covered, and then I put the garlic coil sausage on and this other kubasa. I'm just going to layer all the sausage on top, and we're going to pop it in the oven at 400 for about an hour and 20 minutes. Okay, and then it should be perfectly done. So I'll be back in about an hour and 20.
Okay, guys, there you go. It's done. I might have left it in the oven a little too long, but, I mean, the sausages are still edible. If you turn them over, they're not all like that on one side. They're just like that on one side. It looks good, really good. I'm going to have it with ketchup. I'll put some on a plate and show you what it looks like. There you go, guys. Enjoy. Keto cabbage casserole. Yum, yum, diddly yum.